The interviews for aspirants for the position of Supreme Court Chief Justice wraps up Thursday. Five jurists undergo a public interview by the JBC. The three most senior applicants go first, Teresita Leonardo de Castro, Justado Peralta, and Lucas Bersamin. If she gets appointed, de Castro only has 2 months to serve. She retires this October.
Your Honor, it is not as if that I will start today.
An interesting scenario is if Peralta becomes Chief Justice and his wife, Justice Audrey Peralta, becomes the Presiding Justice of the Court of Appeals, or CA. Justice Audrey Peralta tried to apply for the post of CA, Presiding Justice, but was excluded because of missing requirements.
The man is always above the woman. So if he becomes the Presiding Justice of the Court of Appeals, I can reverse her.
JBC member Toribio Ilao also asks Peralta about his controversial ponencia that allowed a hero's burial for the late dictator Ferdinand Marcos, triggering nationwide protests.
Do you think the Filipinos found closure and the wounded families of the dead and injured by martial law were able to move on?
I hope that issue has already been buried, Your Honor. Because if we do not bury that issue, then we cannot move on. And I still believe that whatever is the past, we have to move on.
Bersamin gets grilled on the increases in his net worth. There was an issue with a condominium unit that Bersamin only declared when he finished paying
it. You mentioned that you purchase, I think it's a condo in Makati.
Yes.
And this is done on installment. But is the installment liability reflected anywhere among your sal-ends?
No, I came to report this only after we already completed the payment, Your Honor. My belief at that time was when you are still paying by installment, it's not yet time for you to declare. Maybe I was wrong, but that is how I did it. And the Compliance Committee of the Supreme Court has not called my attention at all to that mistake, if it was a mistake.
Should there be need for the Council to look further into your and your wife's assets, would you think that your wife would be willing to sign a waiver as well?
Well, as far as that goes, Your Honor, I think so.
Despite his being the second most junior member of the Supreme Court, Associate Justice Andres Reyes says his long career in the judiciary is a good qualification for him to be the next Chief Justice.
I've been a public servant since 1977, so adhering to the court, to the oath, or living and sacrificing under that oath, I have no problem. The hardship of the office, I'm very much used to being an RTC judge. I know the problems and the rigors and the hardship of being a judge in a far-flung place.
To wrap up the interviews, Tagum City Judge Virginia Tejano Ang provides a much-needed comic relief. She admits she did not really intend to apply for the post of top magistrate.
To tell you frankly, I really did not apply for Chief Justice. It so happened that when I applied for the position, that's the vacant. Nagkataon lang po.
But when asked if she wanted to back out of the interview, she says she would rather proceed. The JBC is expected to release the shortlist Friday.